Cervical screening. This is the third video from my cervical series, and in this video we're talking about cervical screening. So cervical screening refers to the use of a cervical smear test to detect premalignant disease of the cervix. This is a national program set up to reduce the incidence, morbidity and mortality associated with cervical cancer. Since cervical screening programs have been set up, the UK has noticed a 20% decrease in the incidence of squamous cell carcinoma of the cervix, as well as a decreasing mortality rate by 7% every year. Now, a quick note on screening. So, screening is a rough sorting process. It's similar to a sieve, where we separate those people who probably do have the condition to people who probably do not. It's not 100% accurate, but gives us an idea if a person is at risk or risk-free. The aims of a screening program are to decrease mortality from the condition, decrease the incidence of the condition, and decrease the severity of the condition. Now, the WHO has some screening prerequisites which need to be met to assess whether screening is appropriate. So I'm including these here just for you to have an idea. So the condition should be an important health problem. There should be an accepted treatment for patients with recognized disease. Facilities for diagnosis and treatment should be available. There should be a recognizable latent or early symptomatic phase. There should be a suitable test or examination. The test should be acceptable to the population. The natural history of the condition, including development from latent to declared disease, should be adequately understood. There should be an agreed policy on whom to treat as patients. The cost of case finding, so including diagnosis and treatment of patients, should be economically balanced in relation to possible expenditure on medical care as a whole. And case finding should be a continuous process and not a once and for all project. Great. Okay, so back to screening. And in this video, I'm going to be discussing the Maltese cervical screening program. Okay, so who do we screen? Under 25-year-olds are not offered screening, and the rationale is that the younger population is more likely to fight off HPV due to their better immune system. Women between 25 and 49 years of age are offered screening every 3 years. Women between 50 and 64 years of age are offered screening every 5 years. And women above 65 are not offered screening because the risk declines significantly above this age group. Okay, so an invite has been sent, the smear test performed, and now we've got the result. What next? So, if we have a normal smear, the woman is sent back to routine screening. If the smear is inadequate, the smear is repeated in another 3 months. If the smear is inflammatory, the smear is repeated in 6 months. If the repeat smear is normal, then the patient can return to routine screening, but if inflammatory again, the smear is repeated again. If the second repeat smear is inflammatory again, then the patient would need a colposcopy. Next. So if the smear is borderline, we have 2 options. So either repeat the smear in 3 to 6 months. If the repeat smear is borderline or inflammatory, then the patient would need a colposcopy. Or else, we can perform HPV testing. So if the HPV result is negative, nothing else needs to be done and the woman can return back to routine screening. If the HPV test is positive, if it is a low-risk HPV, she would need a repeat smear in 6 months. If a high-risk HPV, she needs a colposcopy. Okay, so ELSIL next. So again, we have 2 options, either going immediately for the colposcopy or else going down the route of HPV testing. If we have HSIL, the woman needs a colposcopy. ASCUS also requires a colposcopy. AGUS will require a colposcopy, hysteroscopy, and fractional curettage, since we said that these atypical glandular cells may be coming from the endometrium. So an endometrial sample must be obtained by means of a hysteroscopy and a sample deep into the cervical canal also obtained by means of a fractional curettage. Great, so that's an overview of the management of cervical smears. Now, what does the future hold? There have been discussions about HPV typing as the sole screening test due to its higher sensitivity for detecting SIN when compared to cytology. There have also been proposals of a self-sampling HPV kit making the screening process much easier. Great. So of course we can't discuss cervical pathologies without a mention of HPV. So stay tuned for my next video on HPV. Like and subscribe. Thanks.